Hi everyone! So we're on the eighth week now of our Fruits of the Spirit series, and we have learned just so much about what God does in our lives when we follow Him. We've learned about love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, and faithfulness. And today we are learning about gentleness. Now, my fruit today is the peach. And I've always, it looks quite like a nectarine, but I've always preferred the peach. I like it because it's got that kind of fuzzy skin. And, you know, it's very easy to bruise a peach. And so peaches probably aren't very good fruits to juggle with, but I'm going to give it a go, see if I can do it without dropping it. Are you ready? Oh, almost. That peach is probably now fairly bruised. Because peaches, they aren't just soft, they are delicate, and they also really easily bruise. And I was thinking about our peach and thinking it's a little bit like us. Sometimes we can bruise. And I'm not talking about the kind of bruises you get when you're out in the garden playing football or running around the house. I'm talking about bruises on the inside. And sometimes people hurt our feelings and do things to us that make us feel a little bit flat and a little bit bruised, a bit like that peach down there. And sometimes we can be the ones that are doing the hurting. Sometimes we can make people feel hurt or make people feel upset. And sometimes we think perhaps they deserved it. But Jesus shows us another way. Our story today is from John 8. And we find out a story about a lady. There's a lady and she's done something awful. Everyone is really unhappy. They're angry about what she's done. She's really messed up and they want to punish her. They're angry and they want Jesus to be angry with her too. And they look to Jesus and they're deciding what to do. And Jesus stops them and he shows gentleness in his response. Instead of being angry, he says to the woman, "Go now and leave your life of sin." Now, gentleness is a fruit of the Holy Spirit. And in the Bible, it tells us to let your gentleness be evident to everyone. So show your gentleness to all in the way that you speak and the way that you act. Now, at the moment, you're spending a lot of time with your family. And I'm sure you've had some great times and a lot of fun over the summer holidays, but there's going to be times where there's disagreements with your brothers or your sisters or your parents or with your friends when you see them. And it's so important that we act and speak with gentleness. Our scripture today comes from Proverbs 15:1. And it says, "A gentle answer deflects anger, but harsh words make tempers flare." And so in those moments where we could act with anger, a bit like in our story, we need to be like Jesus and we need to choose not to be angry and not to have revenge and not to argue, but instead to speak with gentleness. And I was thinking about my life and the times where I've had to be gentle, and I think the most helpful thing I could say is to take a pause and to take a breath and to stop and to think before we speak. And gentleness is a gift from the Spirit, so we can ask God to help us with this. And so that's what I'm going to encourage you to do this week. That in those moments where it feels a little bit tense or there could be a disagreement, that you stop and you pause. You think of Jesus and how he acted and how he cared for the lady and he showed love and compassion. And try and speak with gentleness this week. And to finish, we're going to remind ourselves of our memory verse that we've been following through this whole series. We've got it here. Hope you're doing really well filling out your card. And our memory verse is this. The Holy Spirit produces this kind of fruit in our lives. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control.